Before we get this video started, I just want to let you know that I'm doing a $1.25 million shark card giveaway for the brand new Knis free crawler that we're going to be talking about in this video today, as well as all the other items that Rockstar have on sale and the bonuses that are going on. Give a little bit extra as well. So that's going on my Twitter account. I'll be announcing the winner sometime this weekend. So if you're watching this video today, you've got plenty of time to enter. But anyways, let's not waste any more time and let's jump into this. So today's video, I'm going to be talking about the free crawler and some buyer beware with this vehicle. Now, is it me or is just no one hyped for this vehicle? Is it because Rockstar released all these weaponized vehicles first and sort of saved this one for last? Or is it just because it's not a great vehicle? Let me hear from you guys in the comments down below on what you think about the free crawler. Anyways, let's jump into our barrier to entry, and that is price. So the free crawler is not all that expensive, especially by 2018 standards. It's on the Legendary Motorsports site. It's only $597,000, basically 600 grand if we want to round up. So it's not all that bad. Is it kind of pricey for the category it's in, off-road? Maybe a little bit. But again, by 2018 standards, I'm not going to complain about something that's under $600,000, especially given all the prices of vehicles we've seen lately from other cars and other aircrafts and stuff like that. Now, the first thing I noticed about the free crawler when it was delivered to my garage is this thing is kind of awkward looking. Now, we'll discuss that a little bit later on, but that's one of the first things I really noticed about this vehicle. It's sort of just an awkward looking car. But anyways, let's bring this to the Los Santos Custom Shop. Our first vehicle in a while that doesn't require like an Avenger or an MOC or a Terabyte to be upgraded. You customize this vehicle at the good old Los Santos Custom Shop that we've been using since 2013. So that's going to be awesome right there that it requires no extras in order to upgrade. Now, once you're in the Los Santos Custom Shop, you're going to be pleasantly surprised. This vehicle has amazing customization, 24 unique customization options for this vehicle, whether it's deflectors, exhaust, front bumpers, grills, hoods, liveries, side steps, snorkels that you can apply to this vehicle. It's got a lot of really awesome stuff. So you can really have a field day with the customization here, coming up with different designs and unique looks. Another thing I really love about this vehicle, the liveries. There are so many great unique ones, whether it's the San Chayansky Forest Rangers or whether it's the Los Santos Lifeguards. Like, there's so many really cool liveries that you can apply to this vehicle to get some completely unique looks. Like, you can go for like a super urban look, or you could go for something that has more of a wilderness vibe to it. So there's almost no limitations here on what you can create, and that's something I really love about this vehicle. So far, I'd say it's 2 for 2. It's really cheap as far as its price goes. It has amazing customization, and it doesn't require another vehicle or outlet to customize in. So far, things are looking great for the Knis free crawler. You know, I'm sure a lot of you guys are wondering right now, is there any buyer beware to this vehicle? Well, the answer to that is yes, because the next thing we sort of need to talk about is the performance of this vehicle. It's not all that great. In fact, this vehicle is pretty slow when it's all said and done compared to other cheaper and I would say better off-road vehicles like the Knis Camacho. And it's also one you're not going to use in off-road races. Now, this isn't that big of a deal to me. Number one, because it's an off-road vehicle. So speed, not necessarily, or performance, I should say, not necessarily like the thing you're going to be judging this the most off of. And also number two, how often are you doing off-road races? My point exactly. So I don't think it's that big of a deal, but it's just not the best performing vehicle. Let's say that. Now, getting back to what I was discussing earlier with the shape and design of this vehicle, and this is purely subjective and my opinion, I think the shape of this car is absolutely terrible. It kind of looks like an ice cube that got like stretched at the front end, and that's about it. So I like the front end of this vehicle, but the second you turn it around, it just looks awful. Like, there's a back window there that isn't even functional, because it's below the driver's sight line. So if you're driving in the car and you look behind you, you would expect to look out your rear view mirror or your rear window. Well, this car is below the passenger's eyesight. So even if the driver could look out, all he would be doing is looking at the ground, not other vehicles in the road around him. So it is like such a super awkward shape. Even the door in the back opens up in a super awkward fashion that like almost doesn't make sense. So again, that's one of the things that kind of bothers me about this vehicle. I think the shape is a little bit weird. It's sort of like this weird box that I don't think could make up its mind what shape it ultimately wanted to be. Again, that's just my personal opinion, but it is something that does bother me. Another thing that bothers me with the Kniss Freecrawler is I think a lost opportunity here. This thing has like two tow hooks on the front or the ability to like tow something out. There also should have been something on the back in my opinion, but there isn't one there. This would have been a lost opportunity to tow boats or the anti-aircraft trailer, stuff like that. It would have been really cool for Snapmatics or Roleplay or, you know, anything like that. But of course, you cannot do that with this vehicle. Another thing, for whatever reason, you can't do with this vehicle is change the suspension. You would think in an off-road vehicle like this, you'd be able to modify the suspension a little bit. Well, in this case, there is no ability to do so, which is kind of a bummer. Now, I don't want to knock on this vehicle too much because there are some things I actually really do enjoy. It's a fun off-road vehicle. So I talked about how it's not necessarily the speediest or the quickest vehicle, but it does have a lot of torque and initial acceleration. And that torque and initial acceleration is going to make it great for off-roading, climbing up hills, mountains, rocks, dirt roads. It is a blast to go off-roading in, and I think that's what this vehicle ultimately specializes in, just being a fun off-road vehicle. Like, I ended up taking this on top of Mount Chiliad, and it was so much fun. I mean, this thing just absolutely destroys those little dirt paths. You get up there so quickly. So yeah, you do have a ton of fun in this vehicle when you use it, likely for its intended purpose, to actually go off-roading. So I think that's a big plus for this vehicle. And I think that's what it's obviously meant for. Like, yes, you can drive it in the city, but this thing is definitely going to excel, you know, sort of on the beaches or in the woods or in the mountains or in the wilderness. And that's where you're going to have the most fun with this vehicle. Now, another thing I was slightly disappointed, one of the customization options you might have noticed on this car is the snorkel. Now, on some vehicles, the snorkel will actually allow vehicles to drive in higher water without shutting down. Well, in the case of the Kniss Freecrawler, that's actually not the case. Now, don't get me wrong, due to its off-road ability and high stance, it can survive pretty well in high water as long as you're maintaining a normal speed. But that snorkel is not going to allow you to have the water level to rise above the normal engine level of the car. It will ultimately end up shutting down. This would have been an amazing feature of the Kniss Freecrawler if it could really survive the deep waters of the Zancudo Swamp or the shore of Vespucci Beach. That would have been awesome, but unfortunately, again, that's not really the case here. The snorkel is purely cosmetic. It's a bummer. I dislike how they add something like that, and then they make it cosmetic only. So it's a little bit misleading. Like, it's not really all that expensive, but it is kind of unfortunate that that doesn't work really the way that it's intended. So let me give you guys my final review now of the Kniss Freecrawler. Number one, it's a pretty cheap, fun off-road vehicle that has amazing customization. Like, so many different options, which just makes it one of the best vehicles to design for car shows or have fun with. So that's great. It's definitely not the best performing vehicle, but as I've mentioned, it's an off-road vehicle, and that's where it excels, in the mountains, in the woods, the beaches, the wilderness. This car is a ton of fun, but it's also lacking, in my opinion, a couple of really great features, like the ability to tow things, the snorkel, that really would have set it over the top. And overall, I sort of just dislike the shape. It's awkward, boxy, clumsy looking, and I can't really decide what it wanted to be. So overall, I'm enjoying this vehicle, but at the end of the day, if you don't off-road, you're not really getting an overall, like, unbelievable vehicle. Like, for example, if you already have the Kniss Freecrawler or you're happy with the Barrage from the Doomsday Heist, then you probably don't have a need to buy this vehicle. But if you do have the cash and you're looking for something fun, especially if you're going to do like role plays and stuff like that or car shows, this is a pretty nice vehicle. And at the end of the day, it's not all that expensive to buy. So it's something you can get relatively easy. But anyways, that right there is my review of the Kunis Freecrawler. Some buyer beware as well. Let me know what you think about this vehicle in the comments down below. I'd love to hear from you guys down there. Quick reminder, I've got that Shark Card giveaway going on, so I'll leave a link to that in the description. Don't forget about that. Anyways, if you did go on to enjoy this video, though, a like rating would, of course, be awesome. And also, subscribe to my YouTube channel if you are new or you like daily GTA 5 videos like this. With all the way, guys, like I said, thanks so much for watching. Take care, and I'll see you guys in the next video.